Hello there, I'm Phoenix Knight, and I'm actually playing Skyrim this time, as you can see. I do have quite a few, something like 70 mods, so you're gonna see many things that won't be accurate with the vanilla game. I haven't played the vanilla game in about 3 years since I finished it on Xbox. But anyways, this is PC, of course. That is Dovahair, my fine companion. That is Ayla, my other fine companion, and Lydia, my not so fine companion, but hey, she's got a pretty awesome sword. And I had a request from a friend to do some videos on Skyrim, so I thought it'd be an interesting thing to show you guys the Imperial versus Stormcloak war. So I actually just talked to Ulfric Stormcloak over there, and what is his name? Galmar? I think that's his name. The war chief. And they're sending me to the north to kill an ice wraith. So this shouldn't be too bad, right? I may or may not put a list of all my mods in the description. Probably not, because I change them pretty regularly. But I might point something out here and there. I've pretty much got it set up to my liking, so if you want to mod your game, I can recommend some, but it's mainly gonna be finding stuff that you like that makes the game more entertaining for you. But anyways, let's do some fast traveling. Oh man. I have a long distance to run. Would it be better to go to Winterhold or that place? I think it's gonna be better to go to Snowvale. So I think this is actually gonna take up pretty much the whole episode, because I have a long way to go. And I am gonna be using the quick save feature. Because chances are I'm gonna be attacked by some rather bad things. Oh, this is an elven steel sword. It's pretty sweet. I don't remember what exactly is better about it. It's just kind of better than the normal elven sword. It's also got a more realistic mesh, but okay, no problem. So just to fill you in, the would you call it recruitment? The test to get into the Stormcloak army is, I guess it's supposedly generated for each recruit. By the way, this is from Convenient Horses. Horses normally don't have leather armor, so that's the Convenient Horses mod. Anyways, the test is, I guess, the story, as the story goes, it's randomly chosen for each new recruit, but oh gosh, that's a bear. But for me, I have to go kill the ice wraiths. So, oh no. Hello. I think I'm playing on Adept. I would play on Legendary, but battles just draw on for way too long in Legendary. I'm also level 34. Ooh. The hunters are some of my favorite NPCs, 'cause they're so, they're just so, like, they don't take part in any of the just annoying ooh, treasure map. The annoying, like, politics and events that the rest of Skyrim takes part in. Also, my character currently, I've already completed the Thieves Guild, so I've become the Grandmaster, done as many quests as I could find. There's a mod called Sky Complete, and you have to have Sky UI to install Sky Complete, and for Sky UI you need SKSE, Skyrim Script Extender. Those are some pretty... I like those mods a lot. Sky Complete makes... oh, die. Oh, wow. The last time I fought a Horker, I almost died. So that's nice. Now I can kill them pretty quickly. Sky Complete is a very good quest tracker. It basically just lists all of the available quests for everything. I think. I haven't checked because there's hundreds of quests. But it lists all the available quests for, like, side quests, like guilds and things. It's pretty cool. I like it a lot. And Sky UI is a PC-friendly inventory view modification. Basically, it does this. So you get all of your things listed, and there's these little icons, which I really like. There's like four different fonts that you can pick from, and that's my friend. There's like four different fonts you can pick from, and it's really cool. But you need SKSE to use it, and SKSE is so that's another thing I should mention. I'm using both the Skyrim Nexus. I'm starting my game through Nexus Mod Manager. I've also heard about something called Mod Organizer, which I guess works similar to Nexus Mod Manager. Maybe I've never used it. But I'm using the Nexus Mod Manager. I've also got mods straight from the Steam Workshop installed. So some are from there and some are from the Nexus. But the thing I wanted to point out is that SKSE is not available through either of those. You have to go to the creator's website and download the installer and use that. They've created an installer that takes care of everything for you, and but you can't get it through the Nexus, and you can't get it through the Skyrim Workshop. Oh, crap. Nice. The Serpent Stone, hey! Alrighty, fast travel back. Wow, that took a lot less time than I expected. I also kind of expected to die somewhere in there, so guess I'm more powerful than I thought. Oh yeah, so as I was saying, I've completed the Thieves Guild, I've completed the Companions, and I've begun the main quest line. This character, when I created this character, I specifically wanted to complete the Thieves Guild before starting the main quest line. But at this point, I'm kind of like, well, I could either continue completing guilds before I finish the main quest, or I could just do the main quest. The problem with the main quest is, before you complete the beginning of the main quest, you can't use shouts, and I was starting to really miss shouts, so that's why I started it. A crown doesn't make a king. No, are you sure about that?
But this one.
If it even exists.
It exists, and it will be the symbol of the righteousness of our cause. Think about it. The jagged crown.
I forgot about the jagged crown.
Because they loved him. Skyrim needs that king. You will be that king, Ulfric. You must be.
I apologize for any Imperial fans out there, but there are certain reasons that I'm not going to spoil of why I don't like the Imperials. The Stormcloaks are not a whole lot better, but I also haven't done the Stormcloak side yet, so that's why I'm doing this. Yeah, of course I'm alive. Yes, you did. I know I am, even though I'm a cat. Oh yeah, I didn't show you that either. Sure, let's say that. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Sure thing, bro. I wish I knew what fealty meant. Probably like that. Probably just loyalty. Okay, well, I'm gonna do that. Yay! Yep, I'm a girl. Okay. I do swear my blood and honor to the service of Ulfric Stormcloak. Jarl of Vindhelm and Druheith, King of Skyrim. Sorry. As Talos of my wit, as my god, why? Okay, yeah. What you said. Hail Sithis, Lord of the Black Hand. I think I got that wrong, but whatever. Woo! I like trips. No, God, don't give me... I don't have enough carry weight. By the way, another mod. Yeah, I'm going to talk to you later. I'm going to point out a few of my very favorite mods. So some of you might find this cheap. Some of you might think this is lore friendly. Some of you, well, yeah, there's going to be opinions of all kinds. But I'm a cat. I'm a Khajiit. That circlet is from a mod that adds circlet helms. So that does, that's basically an elven helmet that lets my ears stick out. I just wanted a helmet that let my ears stick out, and apparently circlets are the only option. Also, this armor is called Vagabond Armor. I think it's from a mod called, It's Immersive Armors, the Immersive Armors mod. And then you see Elven Gauntlets, Vagabond Boots, the Shield of Visgrimor, the Elven Steel Sword, some Orcish Arrows. And those little black bags. Those are from one of my favorite mods. It's called Bandolier Bags and Pouches. Have fun finding that on the Nexus, because there's like 7 different versions. But you want to find the one that's in English if you speak English. I know that much. Basically, what it does is there's a bunch of different pouch types, and like there's a book holder and a vial holder and all kinds of different stuff. But each different type of carrying thing gives you extra carry weight. So I've got 6 of these normal-sized pouches around my waist, and then the bandolier across my chest. And the bandolier, I think, adds either 100 or 150 carry weight, and each pouch adds 50. So, do the math, I've got 300 around my waist, and, like, another 100 or 150 on my chest. So, and my stamina is 200 and something, 250, I think? 260. 260 stamina. I don't know what that equates to in carry weight, but so I've got something like 700 carry weight. Anyways, that's bandolier bags and pouches, and circlet helms, which I I'm pretty sure that one's from from the Skyrim Workshop. Immersive Armors is from the Nexus. The sword I think is from Immersive Weapons. And oh yeah, and the fact that they're on my back is I managed to get that by combining a few mods, which each mod's page on the Nexus says use with this other mod. But there is something called Dual Sheath Redux, and then there's some animation. There's a mod that like changes the player skeleton so that it works better, and there's one other mod I don't remember. Oh, Dual Sheath Redux, and then there's another mod, and they work in conjunction to allow you to put stuff on your back. So you'll notice most of the time I have my sword and shield on my back. I've got my arrows in the same place. Dual Sheath Redux does allow you to move your arrows, but I like them where they're at. And my daggers go on my back. Basically everything goes on my back. Just to clarify, the daggers don't go on my back, they go on my lower back, where it would make sense to put daggers. Anyways, yeah, I can keep going for a few more minutes. Ooh, the Jagged Crown. I can believe it. Of course we are. Sounds great. Alrighty. I wonder, should I start this quest or should I close the video? Or episode, whatever you want to call it. I think that's good for this episode. So yeah, next episode we're gonna pick up right where we left off and go find the Jagged Crown. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm Phoenix Knight, and I keep talking over these guys. But yeah, I'm Phoenix Knight, and tune in for the next episode. Bye bye.